Thank you. Good morning, everyone. Nice to see all of you in the house of the Lord once again on this beautiful Lord's Day. May the Lord bless each and every one of you for coming. We want to blend our voices with that of the choir to hail this great King of Heaven. We are going to start with hymn number 700 from our CGS, hymn number 700. We would like to appreciate God for His goodness, for His mercy towards each and every one of us. Even as our Sunday school lesson teaches this morning, we want to put that into practice right away as a church to declare today as a Thanksgiving day. It's, every day of a child of God is full of thanksgiving. But since our lesson is pointing to that specifically today, we have desired all our branches everywhere that all our churches and congregation they devote today to praise God. So may I encourage you to just open your mouth and praise the Lord. Amen. You may be here for a different purpose this morning, but you praise and see what will happen. Many times it takes praise to receive. It takes thanksgiving, first of all, before you receive what you are asking for. And that is the approach that we would like to adopt this morning. And we know the Lord will open heaven, amen, and He will accept our songs of praise and thanksgiving. Amen. For our internet audience, wherever you are, we say welcome to you. May the Lord bless you too. We will appreciate if you will be able to join us while the songs that we want to share together will be displayed so that we can all praise the Lord together. And if you're wondering where we are and you'd like to join us physically, we are located on number 95 Fenham Road here in Peckham, London, SE15 1AE. You can join us anytime from now. We're just beginning the devotional service after the prelude from our choir and orchestra. Hymn number 700, we praise thee, O God, for the Son of thy love, for Jesus who died and is now gone above. Hallelujah, thine the glory. Let's take verses 1, 2, and 3 of this song to begin with. Verses 1, 2, and 3. 700. Number 27 from the same hymn book, we use the popular tune, the traditional tune that Brother Tim will play for us to sing that song, meaning that the orchestra will join. Praise my soul, the King of Heaven. Let's take verses 1, 2, and 5. Three verses from this one also. 27. rather say, and can it be that as you gain an interest in the Savior's blood, let's take that song and think on the words of the song, calls for praises from our heart, and can it be?
Thank you.
God bless you all. That's nice, good singing. May the Lord accept our praises. If there is anyone hearing us or present here, still have your chains on.
No.
Today, by the grace of God, as we praise Him for sending His only begotten Son to die for our sins, He can break off that your chain as well today. And we surely do that.
Amen.
Let's move on to majesty. Let's worship His majesty. Majesty. And all the choir members, even watching my conduction, when I did like this, something was telling me they will stand up, but they didn't stand up. They got me. Good choir. You can all be. 699 from our hymn book. 699 from our hymn book. The Song of Jubilee. That's what we will sing today.
Amen.
It shall rain from pole to pole.
Amen.
It shall rain when like a scroll. Hallelujah. Christ in God, God in Christ, is all in all.
Amen.
We take all those three verses. The third verse, we will stand up to sing, and then we shall be led in prayer. 699. Verses 1 and 2 sitting down, and then the third verse, we're going to stand up to sing, and then we shall be led in prayer. 699.
Thank you.
of Jesus.
Our eternal Father, the God of God creation, you made the ants as tiny as they are. You made the elephants. You made man into your own image, that we may spend the entirety of our life to worship you. Oh Lord, we praise you today. Amen. Glory be unto your name.
Amen.
Honor be unto your name.
Amen.
Lord, we worship you.
Amen.
All of us standing here, we have a great heart of great gratitude.
Yeah.
Because you have spared us to be here today. Many who have passed away over the night, many who passed away a month ago, years ago, out of no fault of their own. But your mercy has spared us. Oh Lord, for that we glorify your name. When we are sick, we call upon you and you heal us. When we are hungry, we look unto you, you provide food. Oh Lord, for this we glorify your name. You have clothed us with beauties. We have come out and we can be seen like human beings. We look neat. We look decent. All of this is because of your provision. You give us little ones. You give us older ones. You give us friends. Above all, you send Jesus Christ to this world to be a friend of us, a true friend in this. Oh, the only son that you had, you sacrifice him for our own sake. For this reason alone, Lord, we praise you, O Lord. Glory be unto your name. Today, as you in your eternal throne have declared this earth a day of thanksgiving, you have also declared the heavens of thanksgiving. Oh Lord, we praise you. Glory be to your name. As we are worshiping you, we pray you send your angels, that you send your spirit to abide with us all over the world. What a mystery that you can, in your own economy, guide the superpower of this world, the country of America, to declare a day of thanksgiving to the Almighty God. Who are we to refuse? Lord, we praise you. Oh, we may not have the millions in this world, but we have Jesus.
Oh, yes.
We have a heart to say thank you. Lord, glory be to your name. Come and abide with us. This occasion is for you. We want you to be the chairperson. All that we will do, we want your name to be glorified. Accept our praises and thanks. Honor be unto your name, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Okay, guess what? Today we have our newborn baby by the name Praise, on the day of praises. Isn't that wonderful? That wasn't planned. We have already planned to have our today for Thanksgiving when the Adigimis got in touch with me that they like to bring their baby girl Praise to the church. And I said, what a wonderful, she's replying there now. She's trying to say, I'm here. I can hear you. So we want to rejoice with them. When Praise was in the womb, it is a normal practice to pray for a pregnant woman, even as we heard in the Sunday school this morning, we pray for them. And when now the baby arrives, it is our practice too in the Apostolic Faith Church for parents that would like to bring their babies to the church for dedication. Let me quickly say that there is no moral significance at all attached to this. It's just the parents coming forward to say that they would like the church to pray along with them so that this precious gift of heaven that the Lord has given them, that the Lord will help them to train and look after the baby in the nurture and admonition of the Lord. And we are always very happy to do that anytime any parent would like to do that. So We have Sister Joy and Brother Dapo and their grandparents here with us this morning to bring Oluwa to Biloba praise Adejimi for baby dedication. And we're going to do that in a bit. But we have one children's song that we would like to sing. I learned it first when I was in Norway, and I know some people will know it. We want to learn that song for this baby dedication and sing it together. The title is, Thank You for Every New Good Morning. Thank you for every fresh new day. Thank you that I may cast my burdens wholly unto you. We'll listen to the tune from the team. I've told him to play it twice, and then it's a simple thing that some children will pick here easily. For those of us who are adults who may not be used to this, let's just try and follow and see how we are going to do. Yes, Brad Tim. Again. Thank you for every new good morning. Thank you
for every fresh new day. Thank you for every cast my burdens wholly unto you. Thank you for every friend I have loved. Thank you for everyone I know. Thank you for that of your forgiveness to my greatest foe. Thank you.
To read from the Bible, the Gospel according to St. Luke, the second chapter, for this our baby dedication. Reading about Jesus himself when he was brought into the temple to be presented to the Lord according to the law. That is Luke chapter 2. We see that in verses 21 and 22. And when 8 days were accomplished for the circumcising of the child, his name was called Jesus, which was so named of the angel before he was conceived in the womb. And when the days of our purification according to the law of Moses were accomplished, they brought him to Jerusalem to present him to the Lord. That's what they did even for Jesus Christ. And we know of many examples in the Bible when many little ones were brought to Jesus. Jesus never said, I don't want the little children, I want the adults. He wants both little ones and the grown-up ones. We will remember that even Hannah, when that woman that took a long time before God blessed her with a special boy called Samuel, well, it took some time, but then when the boy was born, the Bible tells us that it took him to the temple. And the Adejimis have decided to do something similar by bringing praise to the temple, to the church. And as I usually said, everybody should remember this. This is not confirmation. This doesn't now mean that praise is now saved. Actually, she has nothing to confess, mm-hmm. nothing to be saved from. So it's not a way by which on the day that she was brought to the church, that was the day she got saved. Nothing like that. No, nothing to confirm anything. As I mentioned earlier on, the main purpose of this is for the parents to publicly declare that they would like, with God's help, bring up this baby in the nurture and the admonition of the Lord. They want to declare that openly, and they would like the church to remember them in prayer. So I will ask Joy and Dapo to bring praise to me here now so that we can have a dedicatory prayer for praise. You can hear us singing already. So when she gets here and the singing is louder, don't let us worry about that. You want to collect your baby first. You don't want that to give it to me. From one, you see now? And now to me. Okay. That is Brother Dapo's style. She's very quiet now. Okay. As I've mentioned, we all want to stand up and pray for this parent and this little girl, that the Lord will help the parents Amen. To do all within their power to raise praise up in the right way. And when the time shall come for praise, to get to that age of accountability, that she will pray to God for forgiveness, that heaven will open and God will answer our prayers. Amen. Shall we all pray? Jesus' name. Amen. Oh Lord, our Heavenly Father, God of love and mankind, we praise you for praise. Yes. We thank you. We glorify your name. We honor your name. We thank you for this day. We thank you for that wonderful day of delivery. We thank you even when she was conceived. You have been with her right from then, even till now. Therefore, Father, on this day, we bring her to you. We present her to you. We pray that we bless her. We pray that we pray for her. We pray that we have mercy upon her. For the parents, Lord Jesus, continue to bless them. More wisdom, knowledge, understanding, so that they can set the right path. They can set the right example for her to follow. Amen. Jesus, please do this for them. Amen. Supply their needs. Amen. Now that they are increased, Jesus, increase their supply. Amen. To look after the entire family. Amen. During the day, look after them. Amen. In the night, look after them. Amen. When praise will want something and it is your design that at this age, she cannot really say it out. But you have a way of telling parents, Jesus, speak to them. Amen. Let them know. Amen. what to do.
Amen.
When no one will be there, just them alone, Jesus, appear to them.
Amen.
And show them what to do. We thank you, Lord Jesus, even for the grandparents
Amen.
That were around to give all their support. Bless them too.
Amen.
Oh Lord, we look forward to that day when praise will reach that age of accountability. And she will acknowledge our sins. And she will acknowledge the importance of the blood of Jesus. And she will call upon you that you will use the blood of your only begotten Son to wash our sins away.
Amen.
As she prays, Lord, answer her.
Amen.
When she will call on you for sanctification, give it to her.
Amen.
When she will call on you for the gift of Holy Ghost baptism, give it to her.
Amen.
Jesus, we want you to make her a pillar.
Amen.
Make her a post in your
Amen.
Church. Continue to look after her.
Amen.
Jesus, it's all about you.
Amen.
Nothing about any of us. You are the only one
yes.
who does it. And you have been doing it.
Yes.
And you will continue to do it.
Amen.
Our heart rejoice. Our heart glorify your name. Our heart honor your name
Amen.
For praise. Accept our praises.
Amen.
Accept our thanks.
Amen.
Take all the glory and honor.
Amen.
For we pray in the name of God the Father,
Amen.
In the name of God the Son,
Amen.
In the name of God the Holy Spirit,
Amen.
All these are much more that you know praise we need, the parents we need, the grandparents we need, your church we need, so that all of us will do our part,
Amen.
You are going to supply.
Amen.
As we pray, in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen. Amen.
You know, she's just looking at me. She's just looking at me. Okay, we continue with our thanksgiving by singing hymn number 664. When Sister Jimoke was teaching the lesson, I can see many of us would like to come in and contribute with what the Lord has done for us. And of course, we didn't have enough time to do that. We want to leave more rooms for those who didn't have the opportunity at the time. We want to give more room for that during the course of this Thanksgiving service for us to appreciate God and thank Him for all that He has done for us. So if the Lord has done anything for you and you like to jump up and praise God for that, this is your time to do so. But let all of us praise God together with this song that says, we give thanks to our God on high that we found the golden way. We give glory, praise, thanks and honor to Father and to the Son and also to the Holy Ghost. We're going to sing all the five verses. At the end of that, we will appreciate some individuals who want to give short, straight to the point testimonies, and then we continue from there. 664.
God is faithful.
Amen.
I thank God for saving my soul.
Amen.
I thank God for sanctifying me and filling me with His Spirit. When this lesson was going on, the Lord was telling me the great deliverance He did for me. I traveled from Kwara State in Nigeria to my own state, Ekiti State. And as we were on the top of a hill, they call hill, the name of the hill is Okeonigbin. It's very high. And I was in a public transport. As we were descending that hill, the tire gave up. And because I knew if the driver applies the brake, we are going to die because it was on top speed. But he managed to try to keep the car afloat, but he couldn't. So the car went into the verge. We were somersaulting. I don't know how many times until we got to the valley. And the distance, no one on top. We know that any of us were in that dish. The way God spared our lives, I can't tell. Not that alone, I went home for a camp meeting 1 year, and as I was driving from Upper Akron, going to where I reside, a drunken driver was on top speed, and he just collided, head-on collision with my car. The way I can, for me to be able to stand on these two legs today, is God's faithfulness.
Amen.
I thank God for all He has done for me.
Amen.
I want Him to help me to be faithful.
Amen.
Praise God with me.
Toothache, and I could not bite anything, and my head was pounding.
Okay.
I don't want to go to the dentist to take my teeth out. Please, God, you gave me these teeth. I want you to heal me.
Amen.
So, miraculously, that is exactly what God did.
Amen.
And I didn't go to the dentist, and I'm healed.
Amen.
And I thank God for what He has done for me.
Gospel, and He saved my soul. As a Catholic, I was very faithful in whatever they told us to do. And one of the things they told us is about heaven and hell, and of course, purgatory. And since I didn't want to stay long in purgatory, I had to do a lot of penance. And we did what we were taught. But I thank God that the war came in Nigeria. I was in the war. And many things happened during the war. It was death. We don't gather too long in a place because if the bomb comes, everybody dies. So death was everywhere. But, you know, God spared my life. And we used to pray then, what we knew how to pray. But God did spare us. And it was during this war that somebody... my friend, we were friends before the war. So when the war came, because she's married to a Yoruba man, they had to leave the Eastern Nigeria. And after the war, during the war, she was crying to God for me. She was telling God, you know she loves you. If she dies, she will go to hell. Please don't let her die. What she was saying in Lagos, I was hearing in Biafra. I was hearing, if you die, you'll go to hell. I said, why will I go to hell? I was going to church. I used to, you know, we do confession, mass confession, and we were told what to do. But that desire, I said, something is wrong. But in the midst of that confusion, the war ended. And she was the first to write me through the Red Cross and said, come straight to Lagos. And when I came to Lagos, she told me, you have to come to camp meeting. It's a long story, but the long and short of it is that when I came to that camp meeting, I saw the choir. And I looked at the choir, I said, God, those people have something I don't have. Although I was dressed well, I had a wrapper and everything, but it's like I was naked. I said, those people, if they die, they will go to heaven. But me, I'm not sure. I was sitting at the very back, but I was looking at the choir. And I said, God, I want to be like those people, you know. But when the word of God came and they started to talk about the salvation, I was the first to get to the altar and I started crying to God and he saved my soul. I praise him for all his love for me. That happened immediately after the war in 1970. And from 1970 till now, the Lord has been faithful to me. In every way, he has been faithful to me. He has kept me alive because he wants to keep me alive. Many times I've died over and over again, but I went to Nigeria once and I came with malaria, and I was hallucinating. And immediately they took me to the hospital. They said, this is a deadly one. Anyway, the long and short of it is that I'm alive in the land of the living, and I have cause to praise God. My son, immediately after my husband died, my son was stabbed, and he had a spinal injury. And that spinal injury, they told me, she cannot walk.
Finish it.
They said he cannot walk again. And I wasn't praying. I was saying, God, how is a young man, he was 21 then, how is a young man going to be on wheelchair for life? But my son called me and said to me, he wasn't saved, but he said to me, Mom, don't ever repeat that I will not walk because I'm going to walk. Yeah. And I said, oh God, that is his faith. And you know what? He did walk. Yeah. They sent him to rehabilitate him. And one day he got up, walked out of the hospital, entered his car, and drove down to London. For this, I thank God. But while he was in the hospital, because he refused to use the wheelchair to do the exercise, he had a blood clot. And they called me from Stoke.
Maybe you help us round up. So
yes.
That,
and they told me that he's going to die within 24 hours, that there is nothing they can do. So I said, okay, this time, I don't think my son will die. So I went down to Stoke Mandeville, and I stood over him. And I said, you will not die. I said to death, you know, I have only one son, but even if I have 10, you are not taking him. I said, can you go back from where you are coming? I thank God that my son is alive today. Yeah. I thank God that after that, all that incident, he gave his life to God. I thank God that he's in the streets now. I thank God for his loving
kindness. Well, I did say that those who didn't, I saw Sister Eunice during the Sunday school, and the teacher too, that is standing and sitting. We had them already, but I think why they wanted to do so is just because perhaps many people are not willing to do so, and they just saw the opportunity, they're jumping into it. But I did say those that we have not heard from may have the opportunity to do so, rather than those who have done something during the Sunday school. Is there anybody? Only one and two. I will give these two chance. But let all of us praise God together by singing Glorious. Glorious is thy name. Then we have Sister Joy. I didn't actually want to put her on the spot. When they were to leave this platform, I wanted to say, can one of you testify? But I didn't tell them before, so I said, don't do so. Now the Spirit of God has spoken to her herself. So she wants to do. And after her, a short one, then Brother Saula from the back, and then we have Sister Joke giving us a solo. Glorious is thy name. Blessed Savior, we adore thee. We thy love and grace proclaim.
Yeah. want to thank God this afternoon for the salvation of my soul. Amen. I want to thank him for his goodness and mercy over me and Amen. Over my family. I want to thank him for how, for his faithfulness and how he's been taking care of us. When I was pregnant, I thank God for the strength that God gave to me. And I was able to run around, to go everywhere. I wasn't really feeling sick or anything. I just thank God for his mercies. And when it was even time for me to give birth, it was like, oh God, I just looked unto him, and the, for the safe delivery that God gave unto me, I really, really appreciate him. And I thank God that since this child has been born, God himself has been taking care of him. He has been blessing us. He has been, and even just this last Monday, the brother clocked four, so he was just 4 years old, just like Monday. And I just thank him, and she herself was 2 months old today. I just thank God for the goodness and everything that God is in. And my parents, God made it possible for them to come over, just to come and say hello to us and then be with us. And I thank you for everything that God is doing. I just want to appreciate him. I pray that at the end of everything, this is what I want to make heaven and be with him forever with my family members. Bless God.
I'd like to say thank you to God for his goodness. I haven't come from a background where I didn't know anything about Jesus. All we did was go to mosque and do routine stuff. But I thank God for his mercy. Amen. This is the best thing that could ever happen to me. We went home this summer, my family, we all went home, and we were supposed to go for 3 weeks, but two out of the 3 weeks was really, really bad because the custom really messed us up. They delayed our goods and stuff, but I really thank God for keeping us and for keeping the children. Every time I go home, when I come back with malaria and I'm admitted in hospital, have to be treated, and that's happened about 3 times, but this time we didn't have any of that, and I was really praying that the children would be fine, would be good, and they were just running around, they were chasing ghosts, chasing chicken, and like, they were really, really enjoying themselves, and God really brought them back. And since they came back, there's been no issue. And that to me, that is a miracle. That is something solid. I've been in hospital many times after I come back from Nigeria, but I thank God for keeping me and my children.
before we go on our knees to pray, let's share a thought from the book of Psalm 124. Psalm 124, let's share a few thoughts there before we go on our knees to pray, to give praise and thanksgiving to God. It says from verse 1, if it had not been the Lord who was on our side, now may Israel say, and I want to say that now may this congregation say, yes. Verse 2, we all read it together. I read verse 1. Now, if it had not been the Lord who was on our side, now may this congregation say, verse 2.
If it had not been the Lord who was on our side, when men will stop against us.
Let's stop there. That's just enough. If not God on our side. Something is beautiful about this. He's not talking of God close by. He's not talking about God somewhere around, but he's talking about God on our side.
Amen.
Isn't that wonderful?
Yes.
You know, the next three verses start with then, meaning that if not for God, verse 3, verse 4, verse 5 listed things that will have happened.
Yes.
And you and I can think back and we can have our own verses 3 to 5 of our lives. But for this writer, then they had swallowed us up quick. It won't take them long time at all to do so, because we are helpless. When their wrath was kindled against us, that's the first then. Second then, verse 4, then the waters had overwhelmed us. The stream had gone over our soul. Then the third, then, in verse 5. Then, the proud waters had gone over our soul. I think there is a lot to fill in that gap.
That's true.
Of then. Yeah. If not for God. If God has not been on our side. All praise, all glory, all honor for God to be on our side.
Amen.
More especially when you think that we do not deserve it.
Yes.
More especially when you look at yourself, I look at myself, the unholiness, the unrighteousness, the unfaithfulness, everything that is anti-God. Still, God says, I will be by your side.
Amen.
Even with your filthiness, even with your unrighteousness, praise God.
Amen.
To be by our side.
Amen.
Have you had an occasion where when you see maybe little ones and other people that want to do something terrible or bad or misbehave to the little one without anyone around, no one to make them afraid of anything. They do anything they want to do. But let the father be by the side of that small one. They will just look and just walk away. That's what the devil has been doing.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
Because he sees God every time by our side.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
I think we heard that over and over and over during our Sunday school this morning. That this great gospel, this great God, worth everything that we can give to it.
Yes.
And that's why when we see some people joking with it, when we see some people not appreciating it, when we see some people not taking it seriously, it grieves our heart.
Yes.
For if God is not by your side, this man perhaps looked back and was thinking, this was, one can think of the song of David. It was said, yeah, David wrote it. And David perhaps will look back and saw how when he was appointed to be king, from nowhere, the youngest of them all, he was made king. Have you seen somebody that is crowned but not crowned? In my study of the Bible, it was David that I found was anointed 3 times. When he was first anointed, you know what? He didn't ascend the throne immediately. No. Isn't that something that you discourage someone? And you will wonder, even when the time came for him to ascend the throne, all that he went through. That was terrible. Perhaps this man looked back. I was thinking about it in terms of what he has passed through. Perhaps he even remembered the time that he committed sin of adultery. God did not just strike him dead. Are you here this afternoon and something is telling you you are the worst of all sinners? We have a song here that says, Jesus is a friend of sinners.
Yes.
He actually declared that I have not come for the righteous. So if you are declaring that righteousness here, yeah, Jesus is saying, I have not come for you. The people that I have come for are those that we acknowledge their helplessness, their sinfulness, their unrighteousness, and they will cry to him for help. He said, that is why I have come. And that is what he has done for many of us. And if something is in your heart on a day like this, you can breathe prayer to that great God of heaven and say, please, you are a God of mercy.
Yes.
I'm even thanking you already because I know you can make today my day.
Yes.
On a day that when people are thanking God for what the Lord has done for them, I want to have it in my life diary that I thank you for that day you saved my soul.
Yes.
And the Lord is able to do that.
Yes.
He looked back at a time when even people in his own house, his own children, they were against him. But perhaps during the time of writing this time, he was just looking back. How did I go through that? If not that the Lord was on my side, I couldn't have passed through that on my own. Can we also look at our lives, situations, things that we are saying, Will I see tomorrow? And you have not only seen tomorrow, by the grace of God, you are seeing now the end of November.
Yeah.
And should Jesus tarry, the end of the year,
yeah,
and should he tarry until so many years that he has designed to give you?
That's true.
Is it because we're worth anything? Is it because we are just so good and so nice?
No.
If not God,
yes,
on my side. You drive to church, you drive back. Going home yesterday, I will be pleading the blood of Jesus on that vehicle at the back. You know, some of them will be driving like as if they just want to push you out of the way. What can you do? At times, of course, when that tailgating starts, just pull aside and let him go and pray for him. And where you cannot pull aside, you just be praying for him. The one will be coming on the other side, you better be pleading the blood of Jesus for him too. That's what we do, and it avails.
Yes.
All the time,
yes,
every time,
yes,
all praises, yes, all glory,
yes,
all honor,
yes,
be unto God.
Yes.
That's what the Lord has been doing.
Yes.
Have you ever thought of you just sleep, you will sleep, you will wake up. You dream of this, you dream of that. Oh, I'm still here. Praise God.
Amen.
Thanks be to God.
Amen.
For our going in and coming out and just doing things that even how we breathe. I always tell people that even to put on my jacket, that I did not put it the other way around. You know, until something happens to any little part of our body, we don't know what the Lord is doing. It's not too much to start from here and be praising God for every part, one by one, one by one, one by one, until you get to the sole of your feet, one by one. For if there is any little thing with any of them, then you will know that everyone is important. And the Lord looks after each part.
Yes.
He does. You pray inside. Pray inside you. Pray for everything within you. The Lord has designed a way by which we praise him we glorify him, we honor him, we lift him up.
Yes.
So on a day like this, I don't want to be guilty. If not for God.
Yes.
If not for God.
Yes.
Look at verse 6. Blessed be the Lord who hath not given us as a prey to their teeth.
Amen.
Our soul is escaped.
Amen.
As a bird.
Yes.
Out of the snare of the fowlers.
Yes.
The snare is broken.
Yes.
And we are escaped.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
The snare.
Yes.
The snare. You know, the picture here is a bird already caught. It's inside the trap. And the fowler is not going to have mercy on the bird because he set the trap anyway. The devil is not going to have mercy on anyone once you are in his trap. But how many times we have been in his trap? And miraculously, he's just like God. He's just like God. He will come and then that's a trap, he break it.
Yes.
He open it up.
Yes.
And then we look and say, wait, am I out? Yes, you're out.
Yes.
The Lord has taken you out.
Yes.
The Lord has taken me out.
Yes.
He's able to do that.
Yes.
Abundantly able.
Yes.
If not for God.
Yes.
Our help is in the name of the Lord.
Yes.
Who made heaven and earth.
Amen.
Our help. Don't look at anybody. Look up to God.
Yes.
Your help, my help, is in the Lord and the Lord alone.
Yes.
And he will continue to help.
Yes.
His help will not fail.
Yes.
Because his faithfulness will never fail.
Yes.
If not for God, you will not be here. I will not be here. Let us worship him. Let us praise him. Let us lift up his name on high from the bottom of our heart. You feel like praising God? Come to the altars. Come to the altars and open your heart and your mind and your life and let God know, if not for you, O Lord, the enemy will have killed me. If not for you, O Lord, sickness will have killed me. If not for you, O Lord, accident will have killed me. If not for you, O Lord, my life will have gone. But for you, I come to praise you. I come to glorify your name. I come to honor your name. God is here, and he will accept our praise as we sing, to God be the glory, great things he has done.
victor. We thank you for rescuing us. We thank you for deliverance. We thank you for provision. We thank you that you are our rock. Glory be to your name. Lord, continue to help us. All our bodies, throw them away. We want to continue to appreciate you. Give us complete victory. Open the eyes of all our children. Help them to love you. Help us to preserve this precious gospel. We know you will help us. In Jesus' mighty name.